Space represents a fairly harsh environment. Any piece of equipment that's exposed to it over a long period of time would require maintenance.
So every time we have to do a maintenance on the outside of the space station, that means a crew member has to suit up and go outside. That introduces that crew member to risk and puts that person in harm's way. The other issue is that now they're spending the time doing the maintenance work and they're not doing the science, which is really what their purpose is. So with the maintenance challenges that we were going to have with the International Space Station, what we found ourselves was Canada being in the position to provide a solution to that problem, and Dexter was going to be that solution.
Dexter is a two-armed robotic manipulator system capable of performing fine motion tasks to replace what an astronaut would need to do on the exterior part of the space station.
Dexter is essentially a handyman. It operates on the outside of the International Space Station. It allows us to do maintenance operations. One of the advantages with Dexter is that we're able to control it from the ground.
And so the ground crew could actually operate these robotic systems and free the astronaut up from that task as well.
So now that Dexter is online on the space station and operating on a regular basis, what we've got is we've got a crew who's spending more time doing science. And this is important because this was really the whole idea of building the International Space Station, was to be able to do science in low Earth orbit.
Unfortunately, only about 40% of women should be getting annual MRI as part of their screening undergo MR screening. Part of the reason why women were not undertaking MRI screening was because of lack of access to the best radiologists locally.
Some women have to drive very long distance, like 7 or 8 hours of car in snowstorm during the winter, sometimes risking their lives just to get their MR-guided breast biopsies.
When we started to do the research with Canadian Space Agency and NASA on the whole remote telesurgery, we started to get involved with MDA. MDA is a Canadian company which has been involved in manufacture of all the robotic systems which is currently used on the space station.
So we developed a system called IGAR, which stands for Image-Guided Automated Robot.
IGAR is a teleoperator robot that performs breast biopsies under MRI guidance.
One of the capabilities of IGAR is to be controlled by radiologists from any distance. And that allows basic radiologists to supervise MR breast biopsy on a patient who may be hundreds of kilometers or thousands of kilometers away from them. It means that the patient can undergo their breast biopsy in their own local hospital without having the need to travel to another city or another hospital to get access to the expertise.
And the results are very, very encouraging. So we've demonstrated that the IGAR is safe, extremely accurate as a human.
And this will allow us to hopefully increase the number of people undergoing screening close to 100% where it should be. So IGAR is built on many of the know-how which was developed for the space program, as well as the software which is also used to control the robotics on the space station.
We can actually see some of these technologies we worked with for a long time becoming available. You know, we have a lot of insight on how to apply them, not just in medicine, but in a number of other fields, which is what we're doing. So without the space station, would any of that have happened? No, not really. Not in that way, anyway.
Subscribe for more space.